Hello, my name is Justin Rossi. I am a cyclist that races with Marc Pro Strava, and Marc Pro is one of our title sponsors, and I'm going to show you my favorite lead placements and how to use the Marc Pro. Last month I wrote on why it's such a great tool, you can read that, but just today I'm going to show you how I use it and where I like to put the leads. Usually I like to put all four leads on one leg at a time. It just gives a better contraction and I get my quad and hamstring and then I move it to the other leg. The four places I put it are on the inside of my quad, my hip flexor, my groin, and my hamstring, and that gets a really good contraction. You can also put it on your calf, which I'll show you, lower back, and your glutes. So right now I'm just going to show you what I do to get it on my quad and what areas give the best contraction. With that said, everybody's different, everybody's anatomy is different, and just moving the lead half an inch to an inch in one direction or the other will give you a better contraction. So you obviously have to experiment with yourself. So this is what I use. It works really well. I've obviously used it a lot. Love the product. So here's what I do. First thing, make sure you don't have any lotion or anything on your leg. It obviously works better with shaved legs. A couple little secrets that Marc Pro won't tell you about. Clean your leg with alcohol, gets rid of all the dry skin, and use a gel, aloe vera, or I like to use this electro gel. I got it on the internet, super cheap, and it gives a way better contraction and makes those pads last quite a bit longer. So I have everything I need right here, my Marc Pro, my pads, and my two little cheat things to get a better contraction. So I'll just start with alcohol, rub it all over my leg, hamstring, all the areas that I know that I'm going to put the leads. I'm obviously not going to show you how to use the gel. You just put it on your leg just like the alcohol. So you got your four leads. Vastus medius, right at the bottom there. If you put it too close to your knee, it'll give you a little knee pain. So I like to put it up a little bit, about 3 inches from your kneecap. Next one is on your hip flexor, up top here, just on the outside. That'll give a real good contraction to your entire quad. Next one, right on your groin muscle. If you use it high, it's pretty good too. If you use it kind of low, it hurts. So I like to go right in the middle. And the hamstring is the trickiest one. So everybody's different. I like to go about halfway up and just put it right in the middle. You got to experiment a little bit with that one. So the next thing I want to show you is how to use the leads. So you have your gray leads and your black leads. So one would think that you put the black leads on your quad and the gray leads on your hamstring. That's not true. It actually gives a better contraction if you oppose leads. So if you're going to do it on just your quads, let's say you want to do your quads at the same time, I put one black on this one, and then I go gray up top. So obviously the same thing on the other side, black in the bottom, gray up top. It gives a better contraction that way. I'll take my other gray lead and do it opposite right there. So this way you're going black to gray, gray to black over here. And turn it up and get your contraction going. Relax for a half an hour to an hour, watch a movie, do whatever. Okay, leaving where we left off, we covered the basics on how to use the machine, a couple little tricks, and the money makers, right? The quad, the hamstring. Now, other than that, I have two areas that I like to focus on, and that's my glutes and calves. Other than that, you can use it anywhere you want, really, except for your head or over your heart. But a lot of cyclists have lower back pain and even up here in the trap area. But you just put it on the muscle, experiment with it. I'm just going to cover the basics today. Glutes. One would think you put it right on the center of your butt. It doesn't get a good contraction at all. So what I do is, here's your midline right on your hip joint here. You come up to your ischial crest. That's right at the top of your hip bone. And I usually go about 2 inches down
and then I come over about 2 inches. So right about there. Luckily I have a mold that I can kind of follow, but everybody will figure their own thing out. That will give a great contraction for your whole entire glute, and if you have piriformis problems, it's awesome. And I find that sitting down with your leg bent like this will give it the best contraction. So usually while you're doing it seated. The next area I want to show you is your calf. One would think you'd put it right directly on your calf. That's not true. I like to put it right on my popliteal area. It's right on the back of your kneecap, basically, right through. I put it slightly lateral. So I don't put it right in dead center. I put it slightly lateral, right there. And that, if you go on each side, glute and calf, you can get a really good contraction. Obviously, gray, black, or vice versa. Just don't go the same color on the same leg. And other than that, experiment, find your best spots, but those are my favorite.